lung cancer is among the deadliest forms of cancer. But a new study joins me now with some details. So they studied like 53,000 people or so, looking at them, and they discovered it's really all about these CT scans.
Right, these CT scans that show a lot. Huh. Maybe a little too much, and I'll get to that in a minute. But let me tell you what they discovered. What they discovered is that if you scan 25,000 smokers, you are going to save 80-plus lives.
Inclusive. So, so should all smokers sitting out there and watching, should they all get screened?
Well, that's where the controversy begins, because CT scans, in addition to picking up cancers, pick up all sorts of other things too.
Like,
so they like just things that are fine, things that are gonna end up with people getting needles stuck into their lungs for ultimately nothing. And so it's a balance. You know, what do you wanna do here? You're saving lives. I mean, just to put it simply, they ought to just stop smoking.
So let's say you're a smoker, if you're not a smoker, could just anyone get the test, or how does that work? And then I guess the obvious follow-up would be, I mean, if you voluntarily get this scan, I would imagine insurance doesn't exactly want to foot the bill.
Right. Chance that they're going to find something benign, something perfectly fine, but then you're going to have to get a needle stuck into your lungs to biopsy it. So this is
some left here, though, scratching my head. I mean, while this is wonderful and they're realizing this is great, especially for people who are smokers, but bottom line, I mean, do you just take your doctor's guidance?
Yeah, you don't when you start screening. So it's a bit of a conundrum.
It is.
It is, and everybody has to make that decision with their doctor. Do you really want to get screened or not?
Talk to your doctor.
That's right.
Elizabeth Cohen, happy Friday.
Okay, you
Thank
too.
Thank you.